What commercial might you be famous for?
Well, one that's been running on your show here for 2 years, for Fixadent. I'm the screaming, fat-faced woman rolling down the roller coaster, screaming for my life, have been for 2 years on your show. And here I am.
Yeah. Yeah. How did you get that part?
I screamed. I auditioned for it. It said, woman on roller coaster. I said, woman on roller coaster? They said, yes. How are you on roller coasters? And I looked around. I said, is this a national spot or is it going to run in Dubuque only? And they said, oh, it's national. I said, I'm great.
I'll take it. Upside down, I'll do it. How many takes did it take?
22.
Really?
22 in a row.
Did you go through the same kids? Were they the same kids?
We killed off about 3 kids. We brought in another child and said, he looks like the other kid. Bring him in. It's close enough. Yeah. Scream again. So
now, we've established that you're 45. Now, that's not old enough for dentures. Are those your...
Yeah, I was bent out of shape. Now, these are my real teeth. When I got the call for it, I said, boy, you know, they're kind of aging me here, and I really got a little pushed. And they said, oh, no, 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 we're going for a much younger market, because there are younger people. I have a major record deal, and I'm talking about dentures.
When will I ever be on this show again? 80s Ladies is a major record. I mean, it's a big hit. And, you know, Jane, you can quote me on the album cover if you want. Big hit, Jane Pauley, Today Show. Yeah. Why don't we play some of the video of 80s Ladies? See, you've embarrassed me.
Was she still good looking? That woman hadn't slipped a bit. The smart one used her head. She made her fortune, and me, I cross the border every chance I get.
Whose home movies are those?
One of the production crew, do you believe that? We were looking for some stuff of mine and we couldn't find anything.
But it looks like everybody's home movies.
It does, it does. Yeah. It's really phenomenal stuff, I think.
This is certainly not a Tammy Wynette song.
No, it's not. It's Tammy Wynette updated, probably. Tammy was as contemporary at her time when she was, you know, happening as what this is. It's just stating as the times have changed.
Now, I want to know about another cut on the album, Younger Men.
What is
this about younger men?
What is this about younger men? You there, younger man. Well, I wrote that in a fit of spring fever up here, you know, when everybody seemed to be running everywhere but me, and they would pass me in the park, these blue shorts and these cute little legs and things. And so I wrote this song about this somewhat older woman turning 40, and she's available, and none of the men her age are, so she starts to turn to the younger ones. And 5 years ago I got my hand slapped about that song. It was much, much, much too much for the radio people to deal with. This time around they're a little bit more receptive.
Okay, when that's the hit single out, we'll get you back and we won't talk about dentures or hemorrhoids or any of that other stuff. KT Oslin, it's good to meet you.
Well, thank you.
Finally.
Okay.
And we'll be back after this.
Okay. Baba Bolton Ba. My next guest is making her first appearance on The Tonight Show. She's been nominated for 2 Grammys in the country music category, Best Song and Best Female Vocalist. Her first album is called 80s Ladies. Would you welcome KT Oslin? Hey, hey.
One.
We stay here, do we, Fred?
Hey, Bobby, would you like to go for a ride in the country with me? I'm celebrating. See the four-wheel beauty of the name.
good to see you.
Thank you.
I love your stuff.
All right.
How are you?
I am dumbfounded at sitting here before
Why?
You.
Oh, come on.
I have grown up with you, and I wasn't so little, so, I have watched you in various stages of undress. Me in various stages of undress. Not you. Mostly in my pajamas at home. I've been watching you since I was a chorus girl and you were still in New York.
Well, it's nice to have you here.
Yeah, oh, I'm thrilled to death.
Somebody told me you used to date one of the guys in our band.
Yes,
is that
I
true?
Did. I dated a sub, a trumpet player sub for you. He went out with you several times, Doc.
Tour.
Yes, he went out on tour, yes.
What was his name?
His name was Alan Rubin, his trumpet player.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah.
Old Al, yeah. You don't have what I would call a typical country type of, it's almost got a little rhythm and blues in there. I mean, it's almost a different beat.
Yes, I'm a very strange hybrid. I was born in Arkansas, raised in Texas, and I lived 20 years in New York City. So it's all in there, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. When I grew up, I didn't relate to country music at all when I was a teenager. It was all middle-aged men drinking whiskey, cheating on their wives.
Whiskey is usually in country songs.
A lot of
I always think you could write any country song if you get jail is somewhere in there, coffee and railroad tracks.
And trucks.
I was on the railroad track drinking some coffee and went back to jail. My dog died, you know. Get those four things and you got a song. Or unrequited love, or the lady who left me, and my heart's dead, and my dog ain't doing too well.
And we don't like cats. No, yeah. I do like cats. No, they're pretty pitiful sometimes, but I try to avoid that.
Yeah, that's good stuff.
Thank you.
You won a Grammy, you won a Female Vocalist of the Year. Everything's going your way, right?
I won everything there is to win and want to win more.
You do. Well, I don't blame you. It's good stuff. I hope you come back with us whenever you can.
I would love
to. Tomorrow you open in the...
Yes, tomorrow, Friday, I open in Lake Tahoe for 3 days.
Yeah.
And in the spring, I get to a headline with Randy Travis.
Hey, great. Yeah, he's good.
Yeah.
And we'll be right back here in just a moment, friends.
I got my brother this great present for
his... Where's new baby? It's this incredible new Magnavox camcorder. It's so light sensitive, it actually lets me take pictures of Sarah at night. And it's fully automatic. With this Magnavox camcorder, I get great pictures in daylight or practically no light.
That's smart.
Yeah, but I still don't know how you could take pictures in the dark.
Simply, you just turn off the lights.
Oh.
Magnavox. Smart choice. Very smart.
It don't taste the same with nothing in the middle. Nothing in the middle. Nothing in the middle, so why eat a cereal with nothing in the middle? When there's apples and cinnamon in the middle of O's. Now there's a new O's with apples and cinnamon baked inside. So why eat a cereal with nothing in the middle? When there's apples and cinnamon in the middle of O's. New Quaker apple cinnamon O's.
Be cool.
CD 101.9. Very cool. Like me.
Very cool.
What makes Pearl different? From a thorough eye exam to the latest in lenses and brand name frames, nobody takes more care to make sure your glasses are right. Maybe that's why more people trust their eyes to Pearl than anyone else.
Nice to have you here. Come back, will you? Tomorrow night at Tahoe. Tomorrow night you're opening. Jerry opens Saturday night. And Bananas in Fort Lee, New Jersey, right?
Right.
And then Sunday you'll be in Peoria, Illinois at Madison Avenue. Mr. Moore will be appearing, I guess, at your home after the show tonight.
I'll be at home.
Yes,
I'll be at home.
Like to give everybody some kind of plug.
With a dead animal of sorts. No,
Wait.
Oh,
wait.
No.
Anyway, tomorrow night, Suzanne Fleshette will be here, drummer man Louis Belson, the Cowboy Poets, Baxter Black, and Carlos Ashley. And I guess tomorrow will be our final, since the Reagans are leaving office, and we have a new president on the... We're doing our final Ronald and Nancy Reagan sketch tomorrow as they pack to leave for California. One last little salute. We'll see you tomorrow. Thank you.
Next, country western star Randy Travis sings on Late Night with David Letterman. Then Sally Jesse Raphael talks it up with Bob on Later with Bob Costas.
Of humor in it, and everybody likes to laugh.
Can you do it, Hector? Can you make music with your nose? I just read Hector, the accordion nose dog, and it showed me how. Hello, my name is Sean Elms, and I really like this book. At the beginning of the book, Hector has one big talent, pointing with the tip of his nose. He won 11 gold medals and even made a movie, all because of his terrific pointing nose. And then something terrible happened. Hector ran smack into a wall. His nose was like an accordion. He collapsed in the corner and started singing the blues. The way he plays his blues is with his nose. In the end, Hector goes on to use his new talent, making music with his nose. I think that you should read this book because it shows you that you have more talents than just one.
Do you ever feel crowd in your family, brothers and sisters, bugging you? Well, that's how Poinsettia felt in this book called Poinsettia and Her Family. Poinsettia has a problem. She has this one favorite book from the library. She can't find one single place to read it in without her brothers or sisters or her mom and dad getting in the way. One day, Poinsettia's family goes to find a bigger house because their house is too crowded. But Poinsettia runs and hides. Now she's got the house all to herself. But Poinsettia finds out that it's not so great to have the house to yourself because it's lonely. I love the pictures in the book. They were really funny. But I like this one special picture. It was of Poinsettia in the bathtub. You know, I have a little brother at home. Sometimes he bugs me. But after I read Poinsettia, I learned, even though I like to be alone sometimes, I still love and care for my family.
A pig from Adidas named Fred looked in the mirror and said, I've a cold in my snout. I shouldn't go out. I guess I should go back to bed.
Today's Pigerics were written by kids across America. They were inspired by this book, Arnold Lobel's Book of Pigerics. You can find it at your library, or you can write your own Pigerics. Are you ready for one more?
There once was a hog from Dallas who lived in a Texas palace. But one custom-made boot didn't fit with a hoot. So this pig was a poke with a callus.
This little piggy went to market, the Honolulu Zoo store in Hawaii. Most of the items in this store have something to do with that smart, affectionate, playful, noble animal, the pig. This polo shirt is by Calvin Swine. It's part of the store's Hog Wild line. I'd like you to see this Pork Avenue collection, so watch as we show you a hand-pigged selection. Move over, alligator. The hog is here on belts, ties, socks, shirts, both front and rear. There are pigs that hold candles and pigs with handles. Pigs on slippers for cold feet and a chocolate piggy treat. Pig etchings, pig earrings, a keychain and key tag. Pig tins and dishes and a hogwash laundry bag. Say hi to Pipsqueak, whose snout you can tweak. Cookie cutters, magnets, paper party goods, calendars, postcards, and ornaments for car hoods. Here's some soap. It's called Hog Lather. Or paper clips, buttons, or stickers, if you'd rather. Open the can with this porcine punch. Or check out this book for a munch, or your lunch. Here's a hot water bottle to warm your tummy. Or some hog-nosed spectacles that make you look funny. Here's a doorstop, a sponge, and a shiny gold charm. Did you ever see this pig out on a farm? Well, we've seen just about everything in this store today but a piggy bank. Say, do you know how piggy banks came to be? Actually, it was a big mistake. See, thousands of years ago, clay called pig, P-Y-G-G, was used to make dishes, pots, and jars. And people used to save their money in these pots and jars called pig. Gradually, the family savings became known as the piggy bank. But then years later, when people wanted piggy banks, the pottery makers didn't understand that pig was ancient clay. They heard the words piggy bank and made pig-shaped money holders. Well, the piggy bank caught on and has been popular ever since. Now, I don't want to be pig-headed or waste any time, but this is a perfect chance to save a dime. Now, I won't overdo this rhyme, so you take it easy, and we'll see you next time.
A skippy doop a doop a boop a rabba dabba dabba ba doo ba ba a skippy doop a doop a doo day hey a skippy doop a doop ba 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 yeah a skippy doop ba 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 and that is why I say I'm happy just being a pig. Why I say I'm happy just to be in a pig.
Sal, how did you like it?
Well, I thought it was